Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team, and today I'm going to be discussing what roles are in NX, why you should use them, and how they can improve your design experience. First and foremost, let's begin by discussing what roles actually are. Roles are predefined settings that control what tools are available to complete your tasks and how these tools are presented on the screen. Roles can be found at the bottom of the resource bar on the left-hand side. Roles for content are organized by user proficiency. We are currently using the advanced role, but there are additional options called welcome and essentials. Let's take a deeper dive into what each one specifically means for our design experience. The first role we're going to explore is this welcome option. The welcome role is specifically tailored for new users and provides the tools you'll need when first getting started. Here, we have the ability to use some of the more simple tools and commands without getting overwhelmed by the more complex design capabilities NX has to offer. This is a great place to begin using NX. The next one we will look at is the Essentials role. Here, we have a few more capabilities, but the tools and commands are still kept to a concise list. You may notice the filter and menu options are now here, which were not included in the Welcome role. This is a great place for beginner and intermediate users as the tools are still limited to those needed for more simple design actions. Going back to the advanced role now, it is clear to see that the variety of tools and selection options is much greater. Here, we are provided with a comprehensive suite of tools for a wide range of tasks across disciplines and industries. This is the best place to be if you're an experienced CAD user in order to maximize your design abilities. Moving on from the content aspect of roles, there is also a section called Presentation where we can optimize our screen layout to fit what technology we are using to design our parts. We are beginning here in the default presentation role. This role optimizes the user interface presentation to best match a traditional non-touch monitor. However, there are a few more options we can look at for different circumstances. If I select the High Definition role, you can see the layout of our screen significantly changes. This option is designed for monitors with 4K resolution and it displays larger bitmaps. However, the content of the ribbon bar, border bars, and quick access toolbar still stays the same. Again, if I now select the touch panel option, our screen layout once again changes. This time, the user interface presentation is optimized to match a touch panel monitor. Once again, larger bitmaps are displayed. But this time, the ribbon bar is undocked and can now be found at the bottom of our screen. And the last option here is the touch tablet role. This time, the user interface presentation is optimized to best match a small touch tablet. Here, border bars and the title bar are removed, though the content of the ribbon bar is the same. Given these customization options, it is easy to match your screen layouts to fit different technologies you may use during your design workflows. In conclusion, in this video, we've discussed what roles are and how they can impact your day-to-day workflows. Content roles control the tools and commands available to match your CAD proficiency. On the other hand, presentation roles help to match the user interface to the technology you are using to design your parts. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.